So, hello students, today we see the important topic that is oxidation number concept. Here oxidation number or state, so they are almost similar, so we can't say it is 100% similar, but so almost oxidation state of an element or oxidation number of an element is almost it is equal. So now we see what is oxidation state and number, what is its importance and how to calculate it. Okay, so first see what is oxidation number means. It is a residual charge. Residual charge means the charge left on that element, the charge left on an element when all other elements are removed in the form of ions from that molecule. So oxidation number of an element means it is equal to the residual charge. Residual charge means the charge left on it, the charge left on that element when all other atoms of different elements are removed in the form of ions. That is called its oxidation number or state. When a single element, single atom ki count chaste, that is called oxidation state antam. So overall any atoms ki, same element ki any atoms unda any atoms ki combined calculate chaste, that is called oxidation number antam. Okay, for example, so definition terms lo cheppalante, if you see, for example, H2SO4. Here sulfur oxidation number is +6 and up. So how to get another? So next we see in calculation. So this is in H2SO4, sulfur charge is +6. Means it is called its oxidation state or number. So one sulfur on the property state and number. So there is no difference. Okay. So means actually the two hydrogens are removed in the form of 2H+. And 4 oxygens are removed in the form of 4O minus 2 ions. So totally ikkada, so final ga migilina enta maniki positive charge, that is +6. So but why you are writing H2SO4 neutrally means the charge of all ions, the 2H+, how much charge? +2. What is the negative charge? -8. So sulfur represents ikkada +6. So +2 +6, that is +8. So -8. Means total positive charge is equal to total negative charge, and overall atom there is no charge. Means generally molecules are neutral. Molecules are neutral and that only any atoms neutral ante. Okay, during the bond formation, in the formation of that molecule, they will obtain different type of charges. But the overall after forming becomes a neutral one, because total positive charge equal negative charge, so it appears it's a neutral one. Okay, some cations, anions, we know that they have some specific positive charges and negative charges. Okay, so now, so our topic oxidation number, sulfur oxidation number +6 and 2H+4O- oxidants, this is the sulfur. Okay. Sulfur present in the +6 form, so it is called oxidation state or number. So means we can write the definition like this. So oxidation number is the residual means remained, left. The residual charge on an atom of an element appear to have when all other atoms are removed from that molecule in the form of ions. Is called oxidation state.
of that particular element. Okay, check it out. This, what is the difference? Oxidation number, oxidation state. It's not a big difference. Okay, but a particular one atom of an element. So a particular one element ki calculate chestam. So for example, in the H2SO4 lo manam one sulfur ki calculate chestam. Okay, for example, in some compound two sulfurs unnay anukondi, two sulfurs ki combined ki calculate chestam. So two sulfur combined ki calculate vachidan iskol oxidation number anta. So individual dani manam single atom ki calculate chesthe that will comes as atomic state, sorry, oxidation state. Okay, now we see what is the exact difference between oxidation number and oxidation state. Okay, so here oxidation number is the total charge on all atoms. The total charge on all atoms of same kind in a molecule of a compound. Okay, the on all atoms. So all atoms ki come calculate this way. So it will be treated as oxidation number if calculated per single atom. Okay. So see the oxidation state. So what is the oxidation state? So it refers the charge per atom. The charge per atom of all atoms. Of same kind in a molecule of a compound. So this is the difference between oxidation number and state. So general ga manam normal ga fluent ga oxidation state number, so casual ga same word use chestam. It is the original difference. Okay, now we see the rules how to calculate the oxidation number, okay, of elements in their different molecules. First we see the rules how to calculate the oxidation number. So it is a very simple one. So rules in calculating oxidation number and state. Okay. Number and state. Okay. Nothing but both are equal. We know the difference. So the first rule. So first rule means the things we have to remember are treated as a rule. The first thing is so oxidation number of we are saying ON. Okay, so oxidation number of a neutral molecule, oxidation number on a neutral molecule is always zero. Oxidation number, okay. So next, the oxidation number or state, whatever, there is no difference in these rules. The oxidation number of an element in its free state. And its free state is also always equal to zero. So here free state means so not a single atom. So single compulsory single atom undan ledu. So an element in its free state means it is not combining with any other atoms. Other atoms means atoms of other elements. So same atoms enna combined avachu. Adhe element related unna atoms enna combined avachu. Of same kind combined avachu. But so other element atoms so combined avachu. Because different atoms combine and electron gaining, electron losing, positive charge, negative charge form. So same kind of atoms are attached. So 22 attached, 3, 4, 5, 6 attached. There is no gaining, no losing. Because same atoms are having same capacity on tendency of electrons. But they all are having zero oxidation state. So for this we can write example free state. Okay? For example, what is oxidation number of chlorine in Cl2? So obviously it is zero. So for example, in the molecule of P4, phosphorus, white phosphorus present in the form of P4, all phosphorus atoms are connected. So its phosphorus oxidation number in P4 is zero. In S8, sulfur exists as S8 also. It is a zero. So for example, nitrogen zero. In the ozone, what is the oxidation number of oxygen? Zero means all free state, so no other elements. So next, so the oxidation number of so generally when state and it will be so single element when we find out this one, but we are saying oxidation state and you said that. Okay, so the oxidation state of one A group elements. Is always equal to plus 1. So combined this combining state law. So it's a zero. For example, sodium. Sodium single ga unda anukondi. So sodium single ga unde. So that's its oxidation number zero. No doubt in it. But in the formation of compounds. And the compound forms is not 1A group elements are having only plus 1 oxidation state. So what are the 1A group elements? We know that lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium. No need of francium as it is a radioactive element. Next, oxidation state of second A group elements. Second A group elements is always equal to plus 2. This compounds, for example, calcium. So what are the elements? You know that beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium, radium. Okay, radium radioactive, but not necessary. Okay, you can write it. Beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium. So why these are having fixed oxidation numbers means 1A group elements, we know general configuration. What is NS1? General electronic valency configuration, NS1. Means they are having only one electron in their valency shell. So after losing that valency electron, they will get nearest noble gas configuration. For example, lithium on losing, it become helium configuration. Sodium losing, it become fluorine configuration. Potassium become argon configuration. So it become a krypton configuration. It becomes xenon configuration. So by losing one electron, they will get octet configuration there, but they always lose one electron. They never accept electron, okay, so they never lose more than one electron, so it's a compulsory fixed one. In the same way, second group elements, we know that it is also treated as alkaline earth metals. They are also having a perfect fixed plus 2 oxidation number in the combined state. So free state law, automatically they are also having zero oxidation state, no doubt in it. But in the formation of some molecules in the reaction, they compulsory exhibits plus 2 oxidation state only, because they are having valence electrons too. After losing the 2 valence electron, they will get nearest noble gas configuration. Okay, for example, we know the calcium 20, losing 2 electrons, it becomes argon. So magnesium 12,
by losing two electron it become neon configuration. Okay, beryllium losing two electron become helium configuration. So they always compulsory try to lose the two electron only. There is no other chance for them. That's why they choose always plus two oxidation state. Okay. Next. So next, the oxidation state of fluorine. Is always minus one only. Because so free state is zero, no doubt in it. So fluorine, we know that it is the most it is the most electronegative element among all elements present in the nature. It is having more electronegative nature. More electronegative nature means having tendency to attract the electrons. Attract this electrons name. It is the first one. So this nunchi manaki. So it is the most electronegative element. But then nunchi nade electron accept chestadi. So this nunchi electron accept chese capacity no other element have. So compulsory. So reaction of participate a compound form this is fluorine gains one electron only. More electron, well, actually it has more capacity got more electron gain this is charge clip because fluorine having seven valence electron in its oxide in its valence shell. Fluorine is having seven electron in its valence shell but it try to gain only one electron. So it become a fluorine become neon configuration. So that's why always in the formation of compounds it shows only negative minus one oxidation state only. Okay. Next, the oxidation state of hydrogen. Hydrogen state is this is a common oxidation number. The oxidation state of hydrogen generally. Commonly it is plus one. So maximum times it shows a plus one oxidation state. But in rare cases means in presence of nothing but in metal hydride. Simply we can say in metal hydride compounds. In metal hydrides, it exhibits minus one. It exhibits minus one. So, for example, take sodium hydride. So, sodium hydride. What is oxidation number of hydrogen? We know sodium compulsory shows plus one only. So, sodium compulsory shows plus one. So, automatically, hydrogen shows minus one only. There is no other choice. Sodium hydride example of sodium having plus, so automatically hydrogen will get minus only because sodium have no other choice. For example, magnesium hydride. Magnesium hydride. So what is the possible for magnesium? Magnesium only plus two. So the two hydrogens H2 minus two. Two hydrogen combined having minus two means one hydrogen is having minus one. Means hydrogen having two possibilities plus commonly it is plus one but only in the metal hydrides it shows a minus one oxidation state. So next the oxidation state of oxygen. So generally it is equal to minus two in all oxides oxidation number so oxidation state of oxygen is minus 2 but it is also in rare cases shows a different oxidation state so that is it shows a minus 1 in peroxides it exhibits a minus 1 oxidation number.
So what is mean by peroxide? So peroxide means O single bond O. O single bond O. Then if you take oxygen, oxygen molecule is coming. So there is a O double bond O is present.
So maximum compounds lo O is connected with other atoms. Maximum compounds lo oxygen is connected with other atoms with a double bond. Maximum compounds lo double bond to untadi. So
but two oxygens are rarely connected by a single bond.
Two oxygen rarely connected by a single bond.
So that is called separately peroxy bond. Okay. This is known as peroxy bond. So in peroxy bond it shows minus 1 oxidation number. I mean here this oxygen oxidation number minus 1. This oxygen oxidation number also minus 1. Next, in superoxides, in superoxide, oxygen exhibits in superoxide, it exhibits minus 1 by 2 oxidation number. Minus 1 by 2 oxidation number. So actually the superoxide definition adjustment, the oxides in which oxygen shows minus 1 by 2. The compounds, the oxides in which oxygen shows minus 1 by 2, they are treated as superoxides. Okay. So for example, so main 1A group elements to superoxides. You see the best example. For example, potassium oxide. So what is a potassium? What is a potassium? There is only one choice, K plus. So K plus carbon, that is O2 minus. So O2 minus 1 means each, but we said it's minus 1 by 2, means each oxygen having minus 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2 totally become minus 1. Okay. So this type of compounds are treated as superoxides. So next, one more important for oxygen is, oxygen also shows, oxygen sometimes also shows positive oxidation numbers also. So positive oxidation number, it should lose electrons. Okay. So manaki ippudaga positive oxidation number possible kaandi entadi fluorine. Okay, because that is the most powerful electronegative element kabatti. So that is the first position. So dan tarvata position, second position lo endante most powerful electronegative element is oxygen. And oxygen takes electrons, accept the electron from all other atoms except fluorine. So if fluorine to combine gunnappudu fluorine is more powerful kabatti, fluorine is more powerful kabatti, so fluorine takes electron from oxygen. So at that time oxygen will get positive oxidation number. So other than fluorine, all other atoms sorry, it takes electrons kabatti negative oxidation number. So oxygen ki positive vachindante in presence of a fluorine only it is possible. It also exhibits positive oxidation number with fluorine. Okay, as fluorine is a most electronegative element. Than all elements. So oxygen is the second position, you know. Okay. So for example, if you see OF2. So OF2 this could be, so fluorine have no other choice. Because minus 1, minus will become minus 2, then O will get plus 2.
means rare cases and nothing but only with fluorine case it shows the positive oxidation state. So next, so these are the main rules. These are the main rules in the calculation of oxidation number of elements. So next, so already we said for neutral molecule, the what is the overall oxidation number and total oxidation state and the zero only. For cations, it's a power plus. For anions, it is power minus. Okay. So next important, so an element. The oxidation state of an atom of an element cannot exceed its group number. So in the periodic table, actually in the original periodic table is given 1A group, 2A group. So manam group number ante 1A, 2A a model this call. Okay, 13, 14, 15 are groups ga general ga 1A, 2A. Or we can say the oxidation state of an atom of an element cannot exceed its group number in periodic table. Or cannot exceed the number of electrons in its outermost shell. Okay. For example, you take sulfur. So what is the maximum oxidation number of sulfur? Is plus 6, because oxygen sulfur, what's 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p4. So what is the valence electron? Totally 6 valence electrons. And so it also belongs to 6a group. 6a group under. So what is the maximum oxidation number of sulfur? Is plus 6 only. For example, in any calculation, if you got plus 7 or negatives lo undochu, plus 6 kanta less enter undu sulfur ki, but plus 6 kanta more it is not possible. For carbon ki plus 4 is the maximum. Next, phosphorus plus 5 is the maximum. Nitrogen plus 5 is the maximum. Okay, for chlorine plus 7 is the maximum, because chlorine is having 7 electrons in valence sheet. Okay, so these are the main points, main rules to remember in the calculation of oxidation number of elements in a particular molecules or ions. Okay, so now we see some examples. So for example, so we are writing some for example KMnO4, we have to calculate the oxidation number of potassium, CK2, Cr2O7. We have to calculate the oxidation number of chromium. Okay, next, so K2MnO4, we have to calculate the oxidation number of that manganese. So underlined element for calculate value. So potassium we know it is always plus 1. Manganese, how much we have to calculate for manganese, say X. How many manganese? One manganese carbon, take 1X. 4. For oxygen, it's minus 2. And overall, it is having charge, no charge, so take 0. So 1 plus X minus 8 equals 0. Here X equals, we will get 7. Means oxidation number of manganese in this compound is plus 7. So here take 2 into 1, 2 chromium, so take 2x, and 7 each oxygen carries minus 2. The overall charge, sorry,
or also at 0. So 14, so 2x minus 12 equals 0. The chromium oxidation number is 6. Here important, the x is 6 and 1 chromium ki 6. 2x, 2x equal to 12, 2x equal to 12 and the total chromium ki oxidation number is 12 and the general oxidation number state combined ka chepestunnam. So, 1 chromium ki plus 6, 2 chromium can add just it becomes 12. Okay. So, manganese 2 into 1, manganese x. So, 4 into minus 2. Overall charge 0. So, 2 plus x minus 8 equals 0. And x equal to 6. So, this is x equals 7. This is potassium permanganate. What is the name of this compound? Potassium manganate. So, this is potassium. The shortcut I am writing. So, potassium permanganate. And we know the ions. Potassium permanganate. This is potassium dichromate. So, this is potassium manganate. Okay. So, direct the compound formulas could idea on that. Simple but pressure formula is channeling JC1 lead. So, direct the what is the oxidation number of chromium in potassium dichromate. So, upper manam the formula idea on that. Okay. So, all we know the ions, ions radicals and manakils cavity. Just we have to revise that ions. In tomorrow class, we see some more examples. Okay.